Welcome to Dig DC, DC Public Library's home for digital special collections. In this video, you'll learn how to browse collections, search Dig DC in different ways, and narrow search results. Before we get started, let's talk about a couple of terms. A collection is a grouping of objects that all come from the same archival collection, like the historical image collection, or a grouping of objects that come from different archival collections but share a common theme, like the voting rights and home rule collection. An object is an individual item within a collection. Objects take many forms. Dig DC has ephemera, maps, newspapers, oral histories, pamphlets, photographs, political cartoons, posters, and zines, among other formats. Okay, let's get started with Dig DC homepage. What you'll notice right away is the slideshow of collections. Click on the blue hyperlink of the collection title to go directly to that collection. Below the slideshow are featured collections. These are collections that are new to Dig DC or collections that have been recently updated with new objects. Click on the blue hyperlink of the collection title to go directly to that collection. There are three ways to find objects in Dig DC: browse, search, and advanced search. On the Dig DC homepage, search is located just above the slideshow. Advanced search and browse are located on the top right navigation pane. Let's start with browse. I like browse because it's a good way to get an overview of all the collections in Dig DC and easily narrow down what to view. The default order of the collections is most recently updated to least recently updated, but there are many different ways to sort the collections. To the far left are the facets, which allow you to sort the collections. Before we get started with facets, it's important to understand that the sorting options are only for the collections themselves and not the objects within. For example, the subjects apply broadly to the collections, but a collection will have many subjects that will describe the objects in more detail. The first facet is the date created slider. It's important to note that the date created represents the earliest dates of objects in a collection and not the entire date span included in a collection. Use the slider to narrow the date created by decade and then hit filter. Or you can enter a date range just below the slider by clicking show at specify date range and entering a date range. The next facet is subject. Dig DC uses a controlled vocabulary provided by the Library of Congress for subjects. Subjects are in numerical order, meaning the subjects that are tagged most frequently in collections are at the top of the list. To view the entire list, click Show More. You can narrow collections by subject just by clicking the blue hyperlink. Remember, the subject just describes broadly what is included in the collections and not the objects themselves. Neighborhood is the next facet. A neighborhood is only assigned to a collection if the objects within are mostly located in a single neighborhood. The default order is the number of collections tagged with each neighborhood. To narrow collections by neighborhood, click a blue hyperlink. The next facet is medium, meaning what form of objects are included in a collection. The default order is the number of collections tagged with each medium. Dig DC uses a controlled vocabulary for mediums. Let's go through each medium. Non-projected graphic is definitely not intuitive, but it's exactly what it sounds like. Non-projected graphic includes photographs, posters, drawings, and other pictorial representations not meant to be projected, like the way a film is meant to be projected. Sound recording are exactly that, recordings of sound. In Dig DC, that's usually referring to oral histories or musical recordings. Texts are publications or documents. In Dig DC, that includes newspapers, ordinances, and zines, among others. Map is all variety of maps. Video recording is a digital moving image, not film. In Dig DC, this usually refers to video recordings of oral histories. The next two facets, publisher and collection, are not relevant in Browse, but they are relevant once you get into a collection. You may want to sort objects by a collection that they belong to or who the publisher is. The final facet, sort, allows you to sort the collection thumbnails by relevance, which is the default, title, which is alphabetically, or date created. Okay, let's click on a collection and see how the facets change. I'm going to select DC Last Colony, Voting Rights, and Home Rule. Now, the facets apply to the objects themselves and not the collection as a whole. You'll see many more subjects, neighborhoods, and mediums, and a new facet type, which is file type, which is the file format. You'll notice that there may be duplicated subjects, neighborhoods, mediums, and formats. We're working on cleaning our metadata, but it's a work in progress. At the bottom of the page, you'll also see a description of the entire collection. Okay, now that we've covered Browse, let's talk about Search. I'm going to navigate back to the Dig DC homepage by clicking the big DC logo at the top left of the page. We can complete a basic search in two ways. The default search is across all collections, or I can use the drop-down menu to search in just one collection. Let's start with a basic search and enter Southwest. Instead of returning just collections, my search has returned 325 objects that are in some way related to Southwest. I can use the facets to narrow and refine my results. Okay, let's go back to the homepage and search within one collection. I'm going to select the Joseph Owen Curtis Photograph Collection, and I'm going to search for cat. Again, I can use the facets to narrow and refine my search, although in this case, it doesn't look like I need to with just four results. Now let's try an advanced search. I'll use the navigation bar at the top right to get to the advanced search. Here, I can choose specifically what field I'd like to search in, and I have the option to add additional fields and limit by collection. Let's try to find objects relating to suffrage that include signs. I am going to select the description field and enter signs. Next, I'll hit the plus sign to create a new field. I can choose which Boolean operator to use, but I'll stick with AND. I could also select or not. I know suffrage is a controlled vocabulary subject, so I'll select subject and enter suffrage. I'm going to continue to look across all collections. Voila! Objects relating to suffrage that include signs. I can use the facets to narrow and refine my search. Here are a few helpful searching hints. To find an exact phrase, add a quotation mark, like quote, apple pie, quote. Or, to search for many variations of a word, you can use the asterisk symbol. For example, to search for swim, swims, swimming, add an asterisk to the end of swim. Thank you for visiting Dig DC. To view other special collections resources, plan a visit, or contact us, use the Visit Us link at the bottom of Dig DC.